The Westfield Technical Academy Aviation Program is the only aeronautical program of its kind in the Northeast, and students who graduate from the program do so with an FAA certification that allows them to work on aircraft. The students split their time between the classroom and the school's own airplane hangar located at Barnes Airport in Westfield. Connecting Point producer Dave Fraser spent a morning at the school recently to learn how this program has really taken off.
According to the FAA, by 2033, U.S. commercial airline carriers are projected to transport 1.15 billion passengers, making aviation one of the fastest-growing industries in the world. Westfield school officials may not have realized that statistic back in 2013 when they formed an advisory board to look into starting an aviation program. But today, that idea has become a reality, and it has put Westfield Technical Academy in the pilot seat.
We are the only high school in New England that's FAA certified. So our aviation program is blessed by the feds.
Galen Wilson is a 30-year veteran of the United States Air Force and, along with an advisory board made up of primarily local employers in the aviation industry, the program at the Technical Academy teaches kids how to maintain aircraft of all shapes and sizes.
So the students are required to accomplish 1,250 hours of training. It takes the students 3.5 years to accomplish this in a high school setting. So there's a lot to this program with the math and the physics and the science behind it.
Part of the students' time is spent in the classroom learning the hands-on skills involved in aviation mechanics. Then they apply those skills at the school's own hangar at Barnes Airport.
They must have a thorough understanding of, i.e. the landing gear, hydraulics, pneumatics, structurals, flight controls, and everything else that revolves around aircraft. They must understand it. We teach the system there at the schoolhouse with our mock-up trainers, and then they'll come out here to our Learjet and apply what they learned on that mock-up trainer to the aircraft, or to the Beechcraft, or to the Piper, or to the helicopter. So lots of options, lots of opportunity to learn.
Some days, however, that opportunity to learn gets interrupted.
Noise. They're a thing of beauty, they really are.
Rim. And then
for junior Faith Young, getting exposure to real aircraft and the mechanics behind it has helped her decide what direction she wants to go in the aviation field.
I hope to become an aerospace engineer and work on spacecraft, but a lot of stuff that can be taken from this program can also be applied to that engineering field, because it's a lot of aerodynamics, learning all hydraulics and everything that's put into an aircraft, but then you're just kind of amping up a bit and putting it into a spacecraft.
Junior Zachary Smith knew he wanted to do something with airplanes ever since he was 5 years old, and after completing this program, the sky's the limit.
From this program, I could take it and go right into the workforce. I would like to become a pilot, so I'm going to go into further schooling at Bridgewater, which they have a pilot's program.
For Wilson, the opportunity to pass on his 30 years of experience to the kids in the aviation program has been very rewarding.
I had aspirations of becoming a teacher, and again, this opportunity came up, and with my FAA certification, along with my teaching desire and my strong Air Force career, put it all together in this program. And as I said earlier, it's been a labor of love. Absolutely love the program, love what I'm doing, enjoy coming to work. Most importantly, enjoy working with the kids and seeing that light bulb go on.